Hello, my name's John Shackleton. I'm the director of The Sleeping Room.
John, it's fantastic to have you at Frightfest. What does it mean for you personally to have your film shown here as part of the festival?
It's absolutely amazing to be back at Frightfest. My first film, Panic Button, was here 3 years ago, but I was the producer. So to have my directorial debut here on this screen in front of this audience is just, really exciting.
And for people who haven't seen the film yet, can you give us a quick synopsis and tell us what made you choose this as your directorial debut?
The one-liner is it's a psychological tale of Victorian revenge set in present-day Brighton. That's as succinct as we can be. Obviously, it's well-honed. The project was, originally I wasn't going to direct it, so we'd optioned it. I'd optioned it as a producer and as a production company. And then through the development process, my producer, Gareth, suggested that it would make a perfect directorial debut for me. I'm trying to work on a bigger film at the moment, but that's always going to be a big leap because it's much bigger budget. So this seemed like a perfect stepping stone film for me. And there were so many really exciting elements within the screenplay that I just couldn't resist, really.
Can you talk a little bit about casting the film?
Yeah, we've been working with Jeremy Zimmerman. Jeremy and Irene at Jeremy Zimmerman Casting on our other project. And they found us Lila Mimock, who is incredible. I knew of her from previous TV work that she'd done and bits and pieces, and she was hands down my first choice. She was great. So they brought in the majority of the cast. They brought in Christopher Adamson, who I was stunned that we could actually afford him and get somebody of that caliber and that level of menace in the film. Absolutely brilliant. Chris Waller came to us independently, and I knew him through Alex Chandon's film Inbred and respected him from afar for a long time, so he was an obvious choice for me as well. And then Joseph Beattie came in only 1 week before we started filming, which was a tough role to fill. And when people see the film, they'll understand why. The character arc, the journey that this character goes on is absolutely huge. So finding somebody who is prepared to go through that enormous range of emotions throughout this movie was tough. And Joseph really rose to the challenge, and he brought his own sort of ideology and methodology to the character. And so much the better for it. He's done a great job for us. So, really thrilled with the cast. It's gone very well.
Of course, we're here at Frightfest celebrating the horror genre. What do you think it gives storytellers and audiences that they perhaps don't get from other types of cinema?
Horror, when it's done really well, kind of holds up a mirror to society, to kind of what's going on. It delves into some sort of pertinent fear. I think as horror, you've got an opportunity to explore a whole range of things. Again, just like I was saying with Joseph's character, you can go on a hell of a ride that you might not be able to do in like a drama, for example. So I think horror just offers a lot more, and it offers a lot more scope for creativity from filmmakers that doesn't necessarily rely on having that big budget or the big marquee names to go in there. So it's a great place to sort of work on your craft, really, and get some good stories told.